Good morning. Today I am going to be filming a full day of eating. It's currently 6:05 in the morning and I am starting with some apple slices. These are just Granny Smith apple slices and then a big cup of coffee. So I typically am a high-end coffee gal. Pete's, Starbucks, those are usually the two that I get, that I alternate between. But my boyfriend introduced me to Folgers Hazelnut, and it is so good. This was like $5 for this whole big thing, and it smells good, it tastes amazing, and I am so shocked. Highly recommend. The coffee creamer that I use is my new favorite from Silk. It's the oatmeal cookie one. So this one is not too sweet. Like, it's a very nice flavor, you know? It doesn't taste very artificial or anything. I really like it. It adds a nice just creaminess to the coffee. If you've been watching me for some time, you know that before I was intermittent fasting. For a couple of months I was fasting, but now I just eat fruit and coffee before noon. So I know I'm not fasting, obviously, but I don't really have any big breakfast. No like starchy carb, like oatmeal or toast or anything like that before noon. So it's just fruit and coffee. And then I start eating my real meals after 12 o'clock. But these meals today are so yummy, and I think all my meals are, but these are very simple. As always, you know, I like to keep it simple. I like to keep it tasty. I add lots of sauces and seasonings and lemon juice or lime juice to add good flavoring. So keep on watching for a couple of good meals. I know you guys like these videos, so I'll keep making them if you enjoy them. The rest of this video is going to be a voiceover, so enjoy the video. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you have not already. Don't forget to like this video and follow me on Instagram. The link will be down below. My first actual meal of the day was very simple but so yummy. So we just have some white jasmine rice, some rinsed and drained black beans, and some tofu. With these, I just cut them into cubes, sprinkled them with a little bit of olive oil and paprika, and kept those in the oven for probably about 30 minutes or so, just for them to kind of get toasty and dry out a little bit. And then topped that with fresh tomatoes, fresh avocado, fresh cilantro, and lime juice, as well as some pink salt. And that is it. Then for my pre-workout snack, these are Morningstar Farms little chicken strips, vegan chicken strips. And I really like these, they're so good. There's already some seasoning, and paired that with some bell peppers for before my workout. And I typically would just eat these cold. It's like a nice, simple little snack. Next is dinner, and I love this meal. It's like a sweet potato curry or stew from One Ingredient Chef. I'll link it down below. It's very, very simple. These are all the ingredients. You need one pot, and you just add some oil to the pot, add your onions, let those cook for a little bit. And one of the important parts when you're making a curry are the spices, and also just making sure that you add all the spices and letting it cook into the onions and the garlic and such. So then you'll stir that, let it cook for a while to get the flavoring in there. And instead of chili pepper, I believe the recipe calls for chili pepper, I use one jalapeno pepper. But after that, you just add the rest of the ingredients, chickpeas, diced tomatoes, I use fire roasted, coconut milk, I use light, and then add one yam chopped up into 1-inch cubes or just similar size cubes, mix that up, make sure everything gets covered, and then all that you have to do is lower the heat and cover it and let this sit for like 30 minutes so all the flavor gets in there and then the sweet potato gets nice and soft, and then it's ready to go, and it's so good. It's best with some rice, but since I had rice with my lunch, I had it with just some bread. I used sourdough bread to dip it in, and it was such a good combo. I did top it with some fresh cilantro, but seriously, one of the best meals ever. Give it a try.